even though this is a developer conference, we can't resist making some improvements to ChatGPT. So a small one, ChatGPT now uses GPT-4 Turbo with all the latest improvements, including the latest knowledge cutoff, which we'll continue to update. That's all live today. It can now browse the web when it needs to, write and run code, analyze data, take and generate images, and much more. And we heard your feedback, that model picker, extremely annoying. That is gone starting today. You will not have to click around the drop-down menu. All of this will just work together. ChatGPT, yeah. ChatGPT will just know what to use and when you need it. But that's not the main thing. And neither was price, actually, the main developer request. There was one that was even bigger than that. And I want to talk about where we're headed and the main thing we're here to talk about today. So we believe that if you give people better tools, they will do amazing things. We know that people want AI that is smarter, more personal, more customizable, can do more on your behalf. Eventually, you'll just ask a computer for what you need, and it'll do all of these tasks for you. These capabilities are often talked in the AI field about as agents. The upsides of this are going to be tremendous. At OpenAI, we really believe that gradual, iterative deployment is the best way to address the safety issues, the safety challenges with AI. We think it's especially important to move carefully towards this future of agents. It's going to require a lot of technical work and a lot of thoughtful consideration by society. So today, we're taking our first small step that moves us towards this future. We're thrilled to introduce GPTs. GPTs are tailored versions of ChatGPT for a specific purpose. You can build a GPT, a customized version of ChatGPT, for almost anything, with instructions, expanded knowledge, and actions, and then you can publish it for others to use. And because they combine instructions, expanded knowledge, and actions, they can be more helpful to you. They can work better in many contexts, and they can give you better control. They'll make it easier for you to accomplish all sorts of tasks or just have more fun, and you'll be able to use them right within ChatGPT. You can, in effect, program a GPT with language just by talking to it. It's easy to customize the behavior so that it fits what you want. This makes building them very accessible, and it gives agency to everyone. So, we're going to show you what GPTs are, how to use them, how to build them, and then we're going to talk about how they'll be distributed and discovered. And then after that, for developers, we're going to show you how to build these agent-like experiences into your own apps. So first, let's look at a few examples. Our partners at code.org are working hard to expand computer science in schools. They've got a curriculum that is used by tens of millions of students worldwide. Code.org crafted Lesson Planner GPT to help teachers provide a more engaging experience for middle schoolers. If a teacher asks it to explain for loops in a creative way, it does just that. In this case, it'll do it in terms of a video game character, repeatedly picking up coins. Super easy to understand for an eighth grader. As you can see, this GPT brings together Code.org's extensive curriculum and expertise and lets teachers adapt it to their needs quickly and easily. Next, Canva has built a GPT that lets you start designing by describing what you want in natural language. If you say, make a poster for a DevDay reception this evening, and you give it some details, it'll generate a few options to start with by hitting Canva's APIs. Now, this concept may be familiar to some of you. We've evolved our plugins to be custom actions for GPTs. You can keep chatting with this to see different iterations, and when you see one you like, you can click through to Canva for the full design experience. So now, we'd like to show you a GPT live. Zapier has built a GPT that lets you perform actions across 6,000 applications to unlock all kinds of integration possibilities. I'd like to introduce Jessica, one of our solutions architects, who is going to drive this demo. Welcome, Jessica.
Thank you, Sam. Thank you all for being here. My name is Jessica Shea. I work with partners and customers to bring their product to life. And today, I can't wait to show you how hard we've been working on this. So let's get started. So to start, where your GPT will live is on this upper left corner. I'm going to start with clicking on the Zapier AI Actions. And on the right-hand side, you can see that's my calendar for today. So it's quite a day. I've already used this before, so it's actually already connected to my calendar. To start, I can ask, what's on my schedule for today? We build GPTs with security in mind. So before it performs any action or share data, it will ask for your permission. So right here, I'm going to say allowed. So GPT is designed to take in your instructions, make the decision on which capability to call to perform that action, and then execute that for you. So you can see right here, it's already connected to my calendar. It pulls into my information. And then I've also prompted it to identify conflicts on my calendar. So you can see right here, it actually was able to identify that. So it looks like I have something coming up. So what if I want to let Sam know that I have to leave early? So right here I say, let Sam know I gotta go, chasing GPUs. So with that, I'm gonna swap to my conversation with Sam, and then I'm gonna say, yes, please run that. Sam, did you get that?
I did.
Awesome. So this is only a glimpse of what is possible, and I cannot wait to see what you all will build. Thank you, and back to you, Sam.
Thank you, Jessica. So those are three great examples. In addition to these, there are many more kinds of GPTs that people are creating, and many, many more that will be created soon.